of heart of mine. It longs for better times, and it sells my girl day.
My girls,
all those great songs my heart still plays. Every Saturday.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to another edition of Tommy Chris TV. We're coming to you video recorded from the Muse. Our special guest today is artist, entrepreneur, impresario, Pammy John. Ms. Pammy John, welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you, Tommy.
As always,
Chris.
And yes. Artist, Pammy John. Art and Pammy John.
In the blood.
Synonymous.
I hope so.
Well, it is.
It's like paint going through my veins. And
paint or instead of blood.
Visuals going through my veins.
I know. I can see that.
Yeah.
We're at the Muse here, and there's just art teeming from every corner of the facility.
Well, that's kind of what my art is all about, Alfie. It's like an enveloping kind of thing where you're inside of the painting as opposed to being outside and looking at it. Just being a part of it and...
Two song cues there. What's it all about?
Yeah.
And I'm on the outside looking in.
Exactly. And that, once again, that's what my art is all about. It's like a song cue.
Yes, mm-hmm. Absolutely. I love it.
Yeah.
So what is your art all about? How would you describe your art?
Well, I'm a decorative visual artist that incorporates mixed media with entertainment. And what that means is, since I've had a heavy background in display work, I'll use the term display because everyone's kind of familiar with that, but I have a heavy background in department stores and working in display and theater. I've done a lot of theater.
Retail, too.
Retail, visual merchandising.
Mm-hmm. They don't do that so much anymore, do they? There's not such a... Unless it's done in the metro areas.
The nature of it has changed. The form of it has changed.
Yeah, no mannequins anymore.
No, the mannequins have changed. Like, way back in the 60s, the mannequins were all smiley face, and their hands were like this, and everybody was happy.
Donna Reed.
And then as the years went on, it got to be real tough,
Models copped an attitude somewhere along the way.
Oh, I got an attitude.
Way.
Go ahead.
They love to have that snarl on their faces now.
Well, that was beautiful, but in comparison to now, they don't have heads. They're just forms. They're just, there's no character. It's more about just the merchandise as opposed to theater. And that was all because of the changes in our society and the technological influence and blah, blah, blah.
So that in itself has become a lost art.
Well, not really. If you go to Macy's at Christmas,
forms are still there, but the mannequins are gone.
Yeah.
So what motivates you, Pammy, to do art? I mean, why art for you?
Well, like I have said many times to myself, as a matter of fact, I think it was Betty Davis. She was asked why she did what she did, and she said, "I've just been born to, and I was driven, and I didn't think about it.
Just did it
because it's like you're just so driven.
It came natural.
It's inside of you. It's like I couldn't let go of it if I, no matter how many times I would fail, I can't let go because it's got a hold of me.
Another song cue. You really got a Smokey Robinson. So how do you do your art? When you decide you're going to do an art project?
I try to get to a quiet place. Like I go within, I research, and then I go out in the environment, whatever the project is. You know, like if I'm going to do a room, or if I'm going to do a backdrop for a play, or if I'm going to paint furniture, or if I'm going to do a painted face. And usually I like to focus first on murals because the backdrops just seem to speak to me. The walls are always speaking to me. And I mean, I
paint
can...
Me.
Paint me. No,
paint
I'm,
me.
No, it's just, it'll say to me like...
Muralize, texturize me. Your background, your influences in art, who do you love?
Well, I'm going to start with my influences because I'm a baby boomer, and I have high respect and high regard for the time that I grew up. And I like to use a lot of those notions that values that I still think work today. I also am heavily influenced by radio, because I think my work has a little bit of a burlesque look. I love comedy, and because I love comedy, that leads to burlesque. A lot of the comedic stars of that era of radio came from burlesque and from vaudeville, like Red Skelton and Danny Kaye and Abbott and Costello. I think maybe even like Gene Kelly and Fred Astaire, you know, watching those kind of movies, that's entertainment, you know, that had played a significant role. A lot of that is still inside of me, and I want to share that and leave that as a legacy. I want the Muse to be part of a legacy so I can share all of the wonderful things that I've discovered in the universe.
So you favor the Greco-Roman?
Neoclassicism, and and I would say
that's apparent here.
And I would say yes, I would say pop art, op art in the '60s, op art became into fruition, and it was just very straight lines and perfection, tricks of the eyes. Not to be misunderstood with tricks of the eyes of Trump de Loyal, which are in murals, which makes it look like it's three-dimensional. But the tricks of the eyes make you think you're seeing something, but you're really not. But that's what it's all about, Alfie.
Oh, no, here we go. And what's it all about, Alfie? Next question.
Which is?
And what is the future? What does the future hold for your work? And what is the purpose of the Muse, for instance?
The purpose is like, it goes back to my idealism and neoclassicism. And I, because I love glamour and, you know, movies and things like that, and that's got have been a heavy influence, I always like making things to the most ideal state. Much like Norman Rockwell, He how can I say this? He made America, he saw it in its most ideal state. Mm-hmm. And he made it rich and masterful and just innocent and beautiful. Let the art have a life of its own and interact with the people so that people, when they view it, it takes them to a new place in their own world. There's a place of escape at the Muse. It's a unique environment that is not like your basic retail and the things that you're traditionally going to. It's a real artist studio, but it's more than that. It's a museum, but it's not. But it's a place for special events. Mm-hmm. But it's more than that. Mm-hmm. You know. There's painted furniture. There's the murals. And whatever else that could evolve, maybe mm-hmm. symposiums could be here. I'm hoping that, you know, that could be part of the future. Workshops, art lessons, all kinds of things like that. Mm-hmm. Whatever the need is in the people to be creative mm-hmm. and get out of their routine and feel better for, I don't care if it's 4 minutes, if they feel better about their life, take it back into their world and they see things in a new way. And I think that's what art is all about, Alfie.
Well, here we go with Alfie again. Okay, so you're going to take us on a tour. But before we do that, mm-hmm. One word.
Yes.
If you could sum up your art in a nutshell. I know this is hard. If you could give it one word, what would it be?
Oh, my favorite word. Wonder.
Wonder.
I love
quick response to
the
it.
Word wonder. Amazement. Yeah, I love that because it's about thinking about things and the Muses. And I got to say this before we close. The Muses, okay, originated back in the ancient Greek times. They were 9 talents that mm-hmm. Socrates had given a personification to goddesses mm-hmm. of. And it goes on and on. It's such a beautiful story mm-hmm. about how learning about the universe, the arts, the sciences, and everything were put in, you know, into these personified creatures that inspire you and to create in your own world. And it just kind of goes on and on. There's Pegasus and Homer and the Odyssey and the Titans and the Cyclopses, and it goes on and on. It's so awesome. And if you could just come and see and learn and see how all those things affect your daily life, even the words from all those times that we use daily, you'd be amazed. So
they're beautiful words.
They're beautiful.
If you can pronounce them.
If you
they're
can.
Beautiful anyway.
Yes.
All right, so now you're going to take us on a tour
yes.
of the Muse.
Yes.
And that should be a lot of fun. So here we go.
A little 5 cent tour.
Yeah. That's more than what I paid.
Bada boom, bada bing.
This part of the room, which is the Roman room, I tried to recreate kind of a Roman facade where the Muses might be involved. I tried to texturize these different parts to give it kind of like a look that, you know, time has passed and there has been some deterioration. In this area, this is my Pompeii art gallery area. I have space here to hang different types of art from different cultures or different eras or different people. And I started off pulling it together with this, actually this piece that when I had, a long time ago, I had done some work, artwork for the Joshua Tree. And one day a lady came in and she knew I was into vintage clothing. And she said, you know, I have this piece of antiquity clothing, and I would like for you to have this because I know that you like vintage clothing. And to me, I don't know exactly the year. All I know is it's falling apart, but it's absolutely fabulous. It's all handmade, and I think it's from the 1800s. This part of the art gallery, which I have tried to reproduce in a mural, is a wall from an ancient Pompeii home. It depicts a Diocesan mystery cult fresco. Anyway, all these different things that I have are artifacts that have kind of come to me, and I like to share them. Like, I found this chair. It's so awesome. I don't know what era. I'm thinking it's probably also the 1800s. And you can see here some of the part of the original cover, and then it has been recovered. And, oh my goodness, what kind of stories must go along with all these pieces? I don't know if you guys ever had breakfast way back in the 60s or the 50s, and or if you would cruise in, I mean, if you would go to one of those diners, or you would cruise in with your friends. But anyway, I try to incorporate some of those items into this area, and hopefully I will add more as time goes on. So anyway, we'll go into this area here. It's another part of the Muse. And I took a painting, and then I wanted to recreate in the painting the movement of the painting into the entire room, which is all about horses and fast moving and kind of doing it in an expressionistic way. And I'm sorry, impressionistic way. And so I texturized it all the way around. And then from here we go into this little bathroom, which is absolutely New York. I built it around this painting right here. And kind of all about romance and the sky being all misty and wet and coming out of a taxi. Kind of a romantic thing.
Heart of mine, it longs for better times.
right here in the middle of Gilligan's Island. This is so cool. There were two pine trees. And these two pine trees are on a real island. There's the coconut hut and there that Gilligan was in, and then the coconut table where all the pies were made by Ginger and Marianne. I tried to incorporate some of the real elements. Actually, if you take a look right over here, you will see the island. And shipwrecked during a 3-hour tour, somehow had endless resources and a genius inventor who could build anything out of a couple of coconuts, but no one in their merry band seemed to have the skills necessary to patch a hole in the boat. Oh my goodness.
Part of the Radio Cafe is an extension of the icons, which would be Charlie Chaplin. And also from a famous scene of one of his movies. Over here,
this is a copy of a Rembrandt, but if you remember the old Bewitched series with Elizabeth Montgomery, which is so cool, in the hallway, in her foyer, as you would go into the house where she was at, was this painting right over, I think it had a crescendo, and of course it was a Rembrandt painting, but this is called The Broom Girl, and it was made by Rembrandt. And if you go and you revisit the old series, you will see that every painting in the house of Bewitched is related to the Good Witch. Oh, but hey. Some of the fun things that I experienced, of course, which was the music. I can remember when my father bought me my first record player, oh my God, and listening to my doo-wop and listening to all the different favorite things that I enjoy. My first dance, I remember the smells and sights and sounds. And, I think I remember the Muppets even were born in that era. And this painting right here, this is about actually my first love. The American Diner, and then my cousins who had influenced me because they were all into music. And sitting around and hearing things on the jukebox. My first car, the Go-Go Girl. My cousins, of course, were always singing, and my first love. Let me introduce you to Pashidu, who is actually a character out of a real temple in Egypt. This is, ancient Egyptians believe that if they put things on walls, they would come to life in the afterlife. And so Pashidu believed that if he was bending over, taking a drink of water in the afterlife, he would be able to be protected by the date palm tree. And here we are once again at Gilligan's Island. A detail that was one of my most important features that I want to express in places, obscure places. Abstraction. This one's all about abstraction. In a lounge, in a smoke-filled room, you can just hear the music going on. In this mural, which is a mythical city called Radio Cafe, and I wanted to recreate the world here. And in this here, I have all my icons in the style of Vincent van Gogh, which is one of his famous paintings about a place where you could go and you could eat a cafe. And I have Laurel and Hardy. I have Groucho Marx. Oh my God, do I love Groucho Marx. Betty Davis, Bugs Bunny, Tweety Bird, Marilyn, and various other characters that are out there visiting and eating and having a great time with all kinds of delicious hospitality. Also back in the background of the Radio Cafe is an ocean where you can find romance while you're sipping on some wine. And inside the Radio Cafe, Nat King Cole is playing and introducing tonight, Tom and Chris.
In the corner of the city, there's a small cafe. And if you get close enough, you can hear somebody say, come a little closer, baby. Welcome to the Radio Cafe. I'm looking for a place I can share my thoughts with you. Sip a little Joe and let the lingo flow into our hearts and minds.
I took the idea of this hallway and I really wanted to make it fun. What do you do with a hallway? And I wanted it to be a continuation of the 60s, so I made it under the sea. I've gotten some curtains, some shower curtains, put them over here and mimicked from this under the sea and made a mural on this side. And here I'm going to put my yellow submarine and maybe I will continue and add other elements. And I gotta tell you, I really, really enjoyed this because I love all the blues and the greens and the movement and the texture. Love the art. Now we're in the actual room where I create the Egyptian room. And in here we have retail, we have pieces of furniture, different things, artifacts that might be of interest to you. This particular piece that I created is actually a reproduction of inspiration from Machu, who was the fellow that invented Art Nouveau. His first works were with Sarah Bernhardt, and I have dance and painting incorporated on top of this piece of furniture. Also, I have a glamour chair with Ann Sheridan. I call it the Ann Sheridan chair. And it's made, you can actually sit on it, you can look at it. It's got lots of detail front and back. And anyway, this is a fun piece that I really love. And I hope that others will enjoy. And yes, this is where I sit, I contemplate, I put my ideas together, I take pieces of furniture that either people have brought to me or that I find, and then I create the works of art on it, and then I also do paintings and also face painting. So I'm heavily influenced, of course, by all the different cultures, the Egyptian culture, the Greek culture, the American culture. I have American folk art that I'm also working on. I hope you'll come. It's been a stone gas. And until then, I hope that you see the world in a whole new way. And always, it's all about wonderment. Guess what? We are now in my office, a little tiny space in the universe where I try to put my ideas together through research. And then also I have things in here, you know, for retail. But I also have things in here that I've done in the past, other adventures that I have done and I like to show. One of my favorite things that I've done is making a very large mural of dinosaurs. Oh my God, dinosaurs are so wonderful. Aren't they wonderful? I'll show you a picture of my dinosaur. I don't know if you can see it very well. But there he is. His name is Christophosaurus. And just one of many things that I've done
Well, guys, we're at the end of the road here, but if you would like to come to the Muse, or you would like a painting or painted furniture or any kind of artistic endeavor, we are going to be having some workshops. And if you're interested, we also will do art lessons. Just give us a call at 330-207-2438. And also, we are at 5234 Southern Boulevard in Boardman, Ohio. We're in the rear of the building. You'll see the Muse. Just give us a call and we'll solve creative problems together. We have many possibilities and the artistic adventures are endless. And thank you for sharing and coming to the Muse.
Someone, but I can't shake the thought of